Privileges offered to micro, small and medium enterprises. Privileges offered to micro, small and medium enterprises. So here they have given some privileges. They have given some privileges to encourage these micro and small enterprises. If they face any problems regarding the buying of goods and services from suppliers, when suppliers are getting late of payments, or if anyone is ignoring the payment, so here they are given some special privileges. The act is also given some special privileges regarding the agreement or regarding the purchase and selling agreements. So here we'll learn about the three types of privileges mainly they are given. That is buyer's liability to make. Here they are given the buyer's liability when they buy anything. So here when they buy anything, so they are under liability. So here when they purchase any goods and services they are on credit, so definitely they are liable for that person action. So here they are given buyer's liability to make timely payment. Buyer's liability to make timely payment for goods and services. Timely payment for goods and services. So here this act, section 15 has envisages to ensure timely receipt of payment. Section 15 envisages ensure timely receipt of payment for their goods and services by micro and small enterprises. It casts an obligation upon the buyer. So here buyer, so it gives the application, it casts the application on the buyer of any goods or services to make payment to the supplier by a specified date follows. So on agreed date. So on agreed date here, a buyer who buys the goods, so from the supplier and so date, he has to pay that amount. So this is what the obligation it gives. So this is what the obligation it gives from that when we buy any goods and services. Next. So here there are two types of agreements, sir. If we are agreed upon something, so there will be two types of agreements. So when there is agreements, so we have to make a payment. We have to make a payment according to that agreement. So that agreement will be on or before the date agreed upon between them. On or before. So it may be. So if I am the buyer, the supplier is there. So on particular date, if I agreed on 10th, so I have the privilege of I can settle that amount before 10th. I can pay on 8th or 9th, but it should not exceed. I can't pay after 10th. So that is what the obligation it gives. So here I have to pay. So on or before the date agreed upon between them in writing. So in writing there is agreement is there, in writing I have agreed. So further, in no case the period so agreed shall exceed 45 days from the date of acceptance. So if there is any no date is given, there is no date is given. So from purchase date, it should not exceed 45 days. So between this before 45 days, they have to settle that amount. Next, if there is no agreement, so they are also the on or before the date agreed upon them. So before the appointed day, which means the date following immediately after the expiry of 15 days from the date of acceptance or date of deemed acceptance. So if there is no agreement, they have some special privilege. So here appointed day means the following date immediately after the expiry of 15 days means if I purchase it, so 15 days were completed. After that, the appointment day will start at that day. So before appointment day, we have to pay that one. We have to pay that. So here, on that day, 15 days from the date of acceptance, that date of deemed as a acceptance. So if there is no agreement, so these are the instructions they will follow. If there is no agreement is there. So these are the things they will follow. So this is what an obligation for timely payment. So next thing. So here, interest for delayed payment. Interest for delayed payment by buyer. So if a buyer got a payment after some time, it has extended. Actually, the time is on 10th, but they paid next month 10th. So there is a gap of 30 days. So 30 days delayed. So this interest will be paid to the supplier. So here they have to pay that 30 days interest. So how much that rate? Actually, that rate will be three times more than the bank rate they have to pay. So here, how much is they are delayed, they will get. Here the supplier has to get that interest. So here buyer has to pay that interest to supplier. So here supplier has to get that interest. The interest rate will be definitely three times more than the bank rate. So that is all. So here, next privilege was reference of disputes. If there is any disputes are there, because it deals with different types of people are there. Here, there may be a term supplier. So, there may be customer and supplier. And not only that, there will be buyer is there. There will be supplier is there. So between them, there is any dispute occur. So if there is any dispute occur, there is one council is there that is called as a micro small enterprises facilitation council. So if they got any case, so they will conduct conciliation in that matter. So they will know about the matter and they will do the conciliation in that matter. So this is what three privileges given by the micro, small, medium enterprises to encourage these enterprises.